let's go.
Hello, people, we welcome Hanoi Rock!
and take a holiday in a Helsinki beach. That's what I'll do. Might mean nothing much to you, but it's everything to me. I'm just inside my sweet poetry. Might mean nothing much to you, but it's the whole world to me. I'm just inside my sweet poetry. Might mean nothing much to you, but it's the whole world to me. I'm just inside my sweet poetry. Might mean nothing much to you, but it's the whole world to me. Yeah, I'm just inside my sweet poetry. There's nothing much to you, but it's the whole world to me. Reside in my sweet poetry. And then, of course, welcome everybody. Tervetuloa. And that is for our new album, Street Poetry. Everybody get it, right? And this is another one from the Street Poetry Masterpiece called A High Wired. A one, two, one, two, three, four.
Remorse. Nice dreamy line. Another day late. Not a dollar to fucking sue. Late at night as I lay down to sleep, I think of all the secrets people keep, like how I feel for you. Do you feel it too? Or is it something we have to resume? We're just two people watching time fly by in a world in its obvious decline. But we are young and strong, we can carry on, find a little paradise of our own. There's no one strange but day, there's no one. Think about how lovely life could be, excluding all the man-made misery. If we're too far behind and really out of time, is there another world they plan to find? Too many days of fear that we never caught. Just a day late, a dollar short. We're all just lonely people, only trying to fall in love. all over my clothes.
Bad news.
It's born in my blood.
Yeah. take you to high school. You trying to get high? You wanna get high? You wanna get high? High on rock and roll! We teach you some fashion, people. Oh.
like, it was dark there. It was cold there. Remember? Mystery City!
Desperate situations to the west end.
wasted years were never meant to last.
Jaded dreams. This was for rock and roll. Anybody out there in love? Anybody out there in real love? It's a true love song. I say it's true. You basically mean it's true.
Need you right now, and right now you're so far away. I guess that I should have known that I'd end up this way, but I swear I'll come home and nothing will drag me away. Don't you ever leave me, baby. Don't you ever leave me now. Don't you ever leave me.
just to walk through the day. All I really wanted to do was sit up in a corner and cry. Nothing had any meaning. But then my baby came along. She made me want to live again and love again and rock and roll again. Yay!
Jumping out of my dreams.
And we're flying fun tonight, right? You want to hear one more song? All right, we got one more for you. Take a look.
million miles away. Hey! Man, I'm around the world goes around. I used to think I was a happy, lucky guy. Now I found my place on earth. Gone back to Europe to stay and be worth. Girls made me happy. Now if I tell you I am from the USA, you believe every word I say. Ain't no fucking holiday. Holidays every day. Let me tell you the truth. If I leave, I'll be a goddamn fool. Yeah, I'm gonna rock till I drop around the clock. Never ever gonna stop. Send you a postcard from Hanoi. They're coming back, so where my babies? I am 10,000 miles away. Thank you, good night. Hanoi rocks, all right.
Tämän illan vieraat.
Tonight's guests are the legendary Hanoi Rocks.
Hello.
Welcome.
Oh. How are you doing?
Hi.
How are you guys doing tonight?
Pretty good. We're all excited about this great show we just did.
Yeah, it was awesome. You guys really rocked.
Awesome. We always rock like fuck. You know.
So
guaranteed entertainment.
We're done with the year 2007. How was it for you guys? Are you pleased with it?
We recorded, I think, the best album we've done so far.
Yeah, Street Poetry.
Career, and it's been a very rewarding year, you know.
And you won a reward as well, the Radio Rock Rooster.
Yeah, we won an iron welded
metal
rooster.
Rock rooster.
Waste of time.
Do these things still mean to you guys
anything?
Well,
it's the first time we ever won anything. Also,
it was about time.
I mean, it was nice to get recognition.
And something and, like that also means something because it's the fans that votes it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that.
Thanks to all the fans.
Everybody voted.
So it means that you are the band in Finland right now.
Well, we've always been the band.
Always been, but you know, still
but now
are.
We got proof.
We're a good rock band and one of a kind, and there's no one quite like us. Definitely have a place in the world.
Nothing, I'm pretentious.
And Mike, you are also, right now, you are being considered as the most important man in Turku.
Oh, that would be a problem. Well, that's what I'm going for.
Does that mean anything
everybody
to you? Or,
of course it does. Yeah. Cool.
So who's your worst competition over there? I'm also from Portland.
I don't know. I don't forget who. Some politicians or something. I don't know. Somebody.
So you're probably going to win then?
What?
You're probably going to win then.
I don't know. That depends on the people.
Turku, yeah.
People
I like
the
living
world.
There. I don't mind living in Turku. It's a nice city and people are nice there. So, you know, it's nice to be recognized and appreciated. So any kind of recognition.
It's
so always
thing.
Been small-minded, so village befits.
Oh, okay.
Funny though, I've always I was born and grew up in Helsinki, so that would be very funny if I won
the most important.
He's there, and his wife's from there.
Probably
so.
Going to happen, I think. But let's talk about the album. I think it's more relevant right now.
Great record.
You're pleased with it?
Yeah.
Has it fulfilled your expectations?
We did like a band. We did it from the beginning.
Very live.
Live, kept it simple, bass, guitars, drums, and vocals, and not too many overdubs. So we captured the band's live vibe and sound better than ever before. Mm. So it very much presents the band.
We tried it before, but we've never done it this successfully before.
But we never had the band together like this. When after AC and Connie joined, the chemistry fell into place with you know, with Lakua and us together, and this is the first time we really had the band chemistry so well in place, and we got it on the record.
So you think this really is your best album to date?
Yeah. The last album we did was just me and Andy and Lockwood, and we didn't have the whole band
Connie together. Was just on a few of the songs.
Connie only joined in the end to do a couple of things, but this one we did from the beginning with the whole band, and arranged everything together and really worked as a tight unit. And you can really hear it, and you can hear that we had fun making it. And
is that live sound the biggest difference to your previous album, Another Hostile Takeover, or how would you
compare? A strong rocking sound, but this is more like presents the band in a perfect way. The sound is really like I said, the band captured the live sound of the band, and we're a live, hard rocking live band. Mm-hmm. And that's what it's all about, really, but performing live. So that presents the band in a perfect way. It's really, really worth getting.
So Mike keeps saying that you are now finally you feel like a band, and this is the best band that Hanorax has ever been. So how do you guys feel like playing with these two? Do you feel like you are Hanorax?
No, we are not playing just with these two. We are playing as a band.
Here I go.
And since we've known each other for a very, very long time, it's just it feels like we have a great
very
time.
Very
natural. We're a band.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so Connie, you wrote some songs on this album. How did that go, writing with Mike and Andy?
Oh, we just, all of us just threw bits and pieces in there and songs, and then we listened and tried to arrange it and see what came out of it. And some of the stuff that I wrote ended up in the album.
So is that no something big that you're going to continue doing, writing together?
Oh, we're all writing. And, if it's a good song, then I think it ends up coming out in some way.
So where's your sound going from now? You think you're going
it's just
to
evolving.
Keep
it's getting better.
It's impossible to say exactly where it's going. I mean, you'll hear on the next album.
Yeah, but it's already there. It's basically there, and it's just getting better.
We have a sound of our own. It's just getting more refined.
Yeah.
So Andy, I read somewhere that this song Fumblefoot and the Bumblebee
Busy
Bee. Yeah. Oh my God! I even have it right here.
No problem.
that you could see that as a soundtrack song for a movie.
Oh,
is that something?
I mean, the song, the original idea came from Corny. I just added a few little ideas to it, but I see it easily. I mean, I could see it in a cartoon. I could see it in any kind of think of Tarantino movies or something like that. Why not?
Is Tarantino somebody that you admire? Is he somebody that you
would
want to work
with? Well, he's just one of the many directors whose movies I like.
Yeah, he's great.
It's okay, so we'll see if that's going to happen in the future. So I've read some of your album reviews, and they have been all very good for this album. But some of the negative things that I thought that were sort of surprising is that some reviewers in Sweden and Finland say that you are trying to copy the sound of Guns N' Roses, which I find ridiculous.
I find that
because
very
you
surprising.
Are the influence. You were the very influence for them.
It's amusing because we were really the major influence on Guns N' Roses was Hanoi Rocks, really. Yeah. So how could we be copying someone who copied us?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Someone was influenced by us.
It only proves the ignorance of the people who wrote that kind of crap.
Yeah, I mean, usually the critics in magazines and stuff, music critics are frustrated musicians themselves, and that's why they want to put people down and look for the negative. And usually every review, they can't, so I can't understand why they can't just say, this is great. And, there should be only fans that review bands, because they would have the knowledge about the band, and then they would also say positive things, because every critic wants to sort of stay above the ordinary people and say something negative in the end always. However, even no matter how great the record, then however, there's the downside. It's just like a habit.
You can't never please everyone. I mean, a good example is we played a festival last summer in Sweden with Alice. Alice played hit after hit after hit after hit. Mm-hmm. And then, in one of the biggest dailies, I think it was Aftonbladet, this guy says, Alice was really dull, old theatrical tricks, and he only had one hit song, poison. I mean, what the hell? What happened? And he played Schools Out, Only Women Bleed. He played I'm 18. He played Heat Up. It was full of like.
Nice guy. Every, you know, like
I mean,
every
Only Women Bleed was like a number one. Schools Out was a number one.
So this guy only knew like Poison. That's the only song he recognized. And he said,
he only played one
it
hit.
It could be that people wanted to just associate you with Guns N' Roses and they didn't know anything else to say. So that's what they said.
No, I think that statement about Guns N' Roses is very negative.
Similarity in the sense that that's a rock and roll band, like Hanoi is, but because there's not that many left anymore. To be honest,
there is no Guns N' Roses anymore.
No, that's true, but I'm just talking about what it used to be.
Well, what about the bands? There are a lot of bands who sort of try to emulate your sound right now. And what do you think? Is there anyone that really comes close to, or that you like currently?
You try to be like someone else and miss the point. Yeah. It's just you know, everyone should find their own sound, and that's it. You know, it's nice to hear that you influence somebody, but it comes down to having your own thing, and somebody finds their own thing. That's always nice to see. But and any kind of imitation is always flattering, of course. But it's no point trying to be like anybody trying to be exactly like us.
You can never be an original. It's like if you look at a painting, you look at a Picasso, and then you look at someone who's learned every trick Picasso used. I mean, he ain't never gonna be a Picasso, the guy who tries to paint like him, you know.
But it's okay to be an influence.
We've been influenced by other people, and we influence others, and that's how it goes on. You know, you gotta have something to refer to. You know, it's all rock and roll. It's good.
So there was a lot of people were writing a lot about your possible tour with LA Guns and the Choir Boys, and that was apparently just a rumor. But is there another 80s band that you really appreciate that you would like to tour with? Or
We'd rather tour with the contemporary band, more like, you know, Foo Fighters or something like that, who's happening now.
Yeah,
like that.
We're not stuck in the 80s.
Yeah, but people seem to get excited about this sort of combination.
A lot of bands live on the nostalgia trip, and that is something we take distance from.
We were not really an 80s band. We never happened that big in the 80s.
It's just rock and roll, you know.
You know, we were then, but we're now. We got. You know, we have our own sound, and it still doesn't sound dated. We're not stuck in the 80s at all.
So we don't have to make that reference anymore.
Yeah, the association with the 80s bands is not necessarily even what we want, really. We'd rather tour with someone new.
And that makes sense. Let's talk about your upcoming tour then. Where are you going?
We're going to Sweden and England, UK and Germany. And
there's a lot of things being planned at the moment, but it's like really stupid to talk about things till it's black on white.
Yeah, but we'll be on tour now in Europe for 1.5 months, starting February.
So what is it like touring? If I came with you, what would I
We have fun because we all like the same kind of music and same kind of movies and stuff. Yeah.
To get to play every night, that's a gas instead of hanging out at home, you know, doing nada.
Do you guys hang out when you're not working together on your free time?
Well, them two live in Stockholm, and he lives in Tampere, and he lives in Helsinki, in Turku. So
we
get together, then we have fun.
We hang out.
So it's not just business for you?
No.
It wouldn't be the other way around.
We wouldn't do this if it wasn't fun.
Rock and roll.
Yeah.
So I
watch out.
Oh.
Time
to eat.
Tangerine. Was it a mandarin?
That's healthy. And I
very much influenced by Tangerine Dream.
Yes, so what?
We all. I was going to say that we're not supposed to revisit the 80s anymore, but I do have to say, and I know that you're going to know what it is. I asked my friends and Hanoi fans in the States and in Finland, like, what would you like to ask these guys? And what do you think is the thing that they all brought up?
I don't know. What's the band doing now? Where are they now?
Yes, that's what it should have been, but everybody said, ask them about Razzle.
Why do you think he's always a part of the band? His spirit was really a great part of the band, and we'll never forget him. And you know, it's a.
But it was his fate. Some of us are gonna die young.
terrible,
just the way it is, you know?
Terrible mm-hmm. tragedy that broke up. That one, it caused the breakup of the band. It led to the break, the early demise of the band, and it's unfortunate.
Just when we
really
were breaking massive, you know. There's, so mm-hmm.
there's no saying what could have would have happened if we hadn't, if that hadn't happened. But there's no point speculating. It's in the past, and that's it. You know, it's unfortunate, terrible mm-hmm. tragedy.
Life goes on.
Yeah, and that's something that, you know, obviously, like you said, was a tragedy. So that's what yeah. people remember, and I guess.
Of course, they always remember the bad things.
With the name, yeah.
yeah. the bad things, not the good things.
But let's get back to the album. Street Poetry, where does the name come from?
It's this bum who used to hang around Ladbroke Grove Tube Station, and he used to write poetry and rant and rave him out. Sometimes he'd be at Hyde Park Corner, you know. I suppose he became some kind of local legend. I mean, I ain't seen him for the last 20 years or something.
We used to
but,
see him
he 80s. Left quite an impression, you know. He was a character.
How did he? How did you remember 80s. Him when you were doing this album? What product?
Andy remembered. Andy's had this song idea for a long time.
I had the song around for, I always have songs around, you know, played and guys liked it, so.
There's a story about the guy behind yeah. here, mm-hmm. and like on the cover of the fantastic album.
Everybody that can read it here.
So, and we, the band sound is, we're like, you know, street credit, we always maintained our street credibility, so that was mm-hmm. always, that was an appropriate
yeah,
name for the band, for the album.
A very live album, so I think it is a great
it's
title.
A fitting name, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Street rock, yeah, fitting name. Yeah. Street rock and roll.
So how do you, you know, you are rock stars, obviously. How do you keep your street cred? How do you keep that?
We are what we are.
Feeling.
We're not trying to be anything.
We're not trying to be anything we're not.
Mm-hmm. We are yeah. just what we are, you know. You don't, we don't like put on the outfits before mm-hmm. we go on stage and then get off stage and put on jumpsuits. And we this is the way we dress every day, you know. I do makeup every day and, you know, it's just like live it 24 hours and it's mm-hmm. what it is.
And this is what it's always been, and it's obviously
it's always
working.
Been like
so.
That, same
yeah,
with those
it's
guys.
Kind of like a religious trip almost.
So very quickly, what would you like to happen in the future for you guys?
Well, like to expand
bigger,
our fame.
Better,
yeah,
get better. Make people aware of the band.
Mm-hmm. Tour wide,
the world.
Very
the
wide.
The more we can be on tour, the better.
Yeah.
Keep rocking.
Yeah,
you got
exactly.
it.
Okay.
Yep.
Thank you so much for
Thank
taking
you.
This time
Thanks
to talk
for having
to
us.
Me and
We're
talking to us.
Hanoi rocks.
Kiitos.
Real rockers, Hanoi rocks. Rock and roll, yeah!